Support for Ukraine has been strong across the tri-state. City leaders, lawmakers, and local Ukrainian organizations came together at City Hall today to reinforce their commitment to helping people in our sister city, Kharkiv, and across Ukraine. Mirella Porter joins us live in studio with their efforts in the last year and what comes next. Mirella.
Hi, Paula. Mayor Avtab Pyrovol made it a point to say this gathering was not just symbolic, but a way to show Kharkiv, Cincinnati's sister city of 33 years, and all of Ukraine that they are supported. In response to the war, local Ukrainians have founded successful organizations in the tri-state. In the last year, they've sent tons of supplies to hospitals, first responders, orphanages, and more. They've also raised thousands of dollars from local fundraising, and some of that money allowed them to send a fully equipped ambulance to Ukraine.
A full year full of anxieties, heart pain, lots of events, sleepless nights, worries about our relatives and loved ones in Ukraine. But the war is not over, we all know that. And therefore we should continue our efforts, our activity to the end, help people in Ukraine.
Bob Herring with the Cincinnati Kharkiv Sister City Partnership says Kharkiv would like to see a delegation from Cincinnati make a visit, though he says conversations are in preliminary stages. A big reason to go would be to sign a new partnership agreement, which expired last year in the middle of the war. The mayor says there's never been a more important time for Cincinnati to reaffirm its support for Kharkiv and the people of Ukraine, and he would support sending a delegation there, though conditions on the ground would be a deciding factor.
They feel a visit from Cincinnati to Kharkiv would do much the same in terms of boosting morale, encouraging the folks, letting them know that they're not forgotten.
A candlelight vigil will be held tonight at the Wyoming Presbyterian Church to remember those still in Ukraine, the refugees scattered across the world, and those who have lost their lives. In the studio, Mirella Porter, Local 12 News.